What's going on, guys? I'm the Inhuman Beatdown, and welcome to a brand new episode of What's in the Box? The series where I make you ask, what's inside of my box? A box of stuff that I've recently purchased, or have, you know, kind of forgotten about in previous What's in the Boxes, but nonetheless, we'll get to this. So, a lot of stuff to go through. Actually, not too much considering previous episodes, but this one's much more heavy on physical stuff. A couple games, couple roleplay things no one will give a shit about, but, so let's go ahead and start the thing off. So, one you guys have probably already seen already if you have watched my beatdown shows off, and that is, there you go, the DX Bright Gunner. This is, from Kamen Rider Drive, Machin Chaser's, Henshin weapon of choice. This is actually why I bought all the, drive shift cars and the viral cores back then. Also because that voice is just absolutely fucking sexy. And unlike most guns or whatnot, this thing fits pretty decently in my hand. It has some good sound effects to it. I was really looking forward to this one. I'm so happy it came. This is by far, like, my favorite roleplay toy so far until I get the double driver. Helped along by that super sexy voice. But yes, the Bright Gunner. Of course, it also has the shift car to go with it, but since I've already shown that off, if you wanted a more in-depth look at that, you can check out Beatdown Shows Off, where I fully demoed the thing with all the shift cars. Continuing on to another trend of things, I also have something I should have shown off a while back, because I got this, actually, I think after the first Beatdown Shows Off, this is the HEHAT gun. This is the weapon for Flame States, Forze. There we go. It's kind of even a flamethrower or fire extinguisher look to it, because that's what it is. It also comes with the fire Forze switch, which was mostly my main reason for getting this, because this thing is kind of tiny. In the show, it's supposed to be a two-handed weapon, but in my hands, it's super small. Like, the trigger is right here, and both my hands basically almost take up this entire weapon. Also, it does detach for fire extinguisher mode. But like I said, I mostly just bought it for the Astro Switch. But decent sounds to it. But not really something I'd go around like. Not really something I enjoy as much as I did the Brake Gunner. Last thing on our roleplay adventure is. Why don't you introduce yourself? This is. Kivat. Not Kivat. Tossalot. Kivat is the belt. Tossalot is the super form upgrade for Kamen Rider Kiva. He's sort of like a drake, I think. He kind of has this dragon appearance to him. I kind of wish anything else moved on him. And he also comes with the whistle for Kivat. It doesn't really do anything except activate his noise. I really wish it made Kivat say Tossalot, but yeah. Nonetheless, he talks. Or he would if I didn't have him activate on the other thing. So. Said something to Kivat, that's all I know. He basically goes with this armband here. Which goes on the arm, as you would think. to activate Emperor mode for Kiva. You'll notice I've only got one belt on here. That's because the belt straps it comes with is are super tiny, considering... I don't know if it shows off real well here, but there is a curve here where it's like it goes under here and then it has to get stuck right here, bending even more coming back through. And it's stupid design. Like, you can see, like, right here, it's bent. And that's just how the design of this arm thing is. And because of it, the original armbands wouldn't work, so I had to steal the Mega Ulorder's armband. I had to replace the Mega Ulorder with another belt because I destroyed my other one trying to, retrofit it on here, which is what all this damage is right here, because I actually got this guy new. But overall, he's okay. He's very loud, though. There we go, I got Wake Up. He's decent, if not really shrill and real random, which stops me from enjoying him just a little bit. Outside of that, though, we've got games. So, oh man, who's ready for all their 13, ready for every 13-year-old prepubescent boy's wet dream? I give you Konami's classic. Classic, of course, being a vague word. This is Rumble Roses! Man, it is exactly what you think it is. This is an all-female wrestling game for the PlayStation 2. All-female wrestling. Face it, you've always wanted it. 1UP.com. A story mode you won't forget. Lethal moves and looks that kill. Ruthless submission holds. Get dirty in mud mode. Looks amazing. Plays fantastic. It's a very, very shallow wrestling game. You can easily beat it in no time flat. The main gimmick here is to look at the girls and see how attractively undressed they are and jack one out to them. That's literally the only point of this game. That and to sell Konami's other games, because all the all the advertisement in the games are Konami games, such as Castlevania and Metal Gear Solid. You know, when they were making those. Anyways. Yeah, so, you may be asking, why do I have this if it sucks so bad? Well, I paid about $5 for both of these, together. I paid $2 for the English one, and I paid $3 for the Japanese one. You may be asking, why do I have the Japanese one? Well, aside from tactfully marketing the game a little bit better, even though it also likes to call attention to mud mode, it actually shows off the interesting feature of this game, that being the vow system. A system in which case you can, for those unfamiliar with wrestling terminology, turn a character to a heel, or that's a typical bad guy, you know. They do bad things, they taunt people, they do like... they get weapons from underneath the stage, you know, typical shit like that. Or a face, the good guy, the goody-goody two-shoes. And every character has a heel and a face. Some start off heel, some start off face, you get the idea. It's a pretty cool system. As such, we hear the main character Reiko here in her face form, and as her heel, which makes her blonde and she now has a scar for some reason. I don't really know. But yeah. Unfortunately, this one loses points because it also advertises gallery mode, which is literally just watching the 3D model of the girl. And it's not creepy at all. I bought, the reason I got the Japanese version is because the Japanese has one character that the PS2, that the English did not. Removed from it is a character by the name of Sebastian. He is a clown gimp for one of the characters known as Mistress Spencer. He is playable in the Japanese version. He was removed from the English version, which doesn't make any sense at all, considering they would put him back in the English version for the sequel. Yes, this game got a sequel. Ugh. This game is not good. Play it out of curiosity. Don't pay more than $10. Don't pay more than $5 if you can help it. Next on my list is a game that needs no introduction. But it does need help getting out of the box. That is, of course, Halo Combat Evolved. Do I really need to say anything? Who doesn't know what Halo is? For those unfamiliar and uneducated gamers, this is Halo Combat Evolved, the first game for the original Xbox. This is specifically the Game of the Year edition. I don't think there's any difference. running out of breath. Whew. But this is the original version. With all the goodness, such as indestructible vehicles and health kits. Because health didn't accumulate over time. Really fun game. I wanted it because I was collecting the Halo series, just because I think at this time all I have is Halo Wars and Halo... I think I have Halo ODST, and I think I have the limited edition version of Halo Reach. But I wanted the entire Halo set, because you know me, if I'm going to record a game, I want to start at the beginning and work my way, like, release order-wise, so, yeah. Halo. Which also meant that I went and picked up... Come on. It's always hard to get them out when it's the last thing in the box. There we go. The limited edition version of Halo 3. Yes. I wanted to pick up every limited edition version of all the Halos, which isn't as expensive as it sounds. This one ran me $20. And I made sure to get it with everything, including the plastic cover here, which oftentimes is missing. Outside of that, it's a pretty solid tin can with multiple discs. I'll make note, though, if you do buy this game, be careful. These things right here are really shitty and barely hold the game in place. I actually specifically asked the person I bought this from to put them in a separate holder. This is also a bonus disc. To put them in separate disc containers, because this thing is known for, like, those just falling off. And then it's like, oh boy, this thing is already in the mail where it's getting, like, thrown around and trashed all around. Oh man, I'm sure those discs are gonna survive that travel. But, yes. And the guy was nice and was like, oh yeah, no problem, dude. I'll do it. Whereas, like, another seller was like, man, this case of Halo 3 is completely unopened. You can hear some rattling inside of it, though. I'm like, are you saying the discs are rattling inside there? Yeah. Duh. Why the fuck would I buy that? You're telling me the discs are just shaking around in its case and getting scratched up all to hell and probably don't work? Why the fuck am I gonna buy that? But yeah, Halo 3, third game. Alright, so sorry about that. I apparently ran out of space on my camera. So yeah, that was fun. Anyway, so as I was saying, third game in the series. I mean, what can I possibly say that people don't know about this already? I've been trying to collect the limited editions of games. I've had several for the second game lined up, which is probably my favorite of the game series, but each one is kind of missing this, like, plastic to it that's over the top of it. And the problem is, it's like, I display my games kind of like sideways like this or long ways, and it's like, cool, Halo 3, I know what that is. And since the second one also has kind of like a case like this, but it's silver, it also looks like this, so it's like displayed sideways. Cool, black square box the game. My favorite. But yeah, that's pretty much it for what's in the box. Not too many things this time around. A lot of things has just been, I've had them around, I've just kind of forgotten about them for the most part, and a lot of other things just been, I just haven't gotten around to it pretty much. Right now I'm trying to work on getting taxes done and all that, you know, fun times, adulting and whatnot, so nothing else really new has come in. Probably won't be for a bit, maybe. If and when I get a new job, we'll have some new stuff then, and so then you can come back and see what's in the box. So until next time, guys, I'll catch you all later. Hasta.